How can you ensure that your city's investments in flood management and resiliency provides the safety level that you're after and at the same time delivers and contributes to the city livability? My name is Christian Nyrup Nielsen and I'm Director for Climate Adaptation and Landscape in Ramboll. All over the world, cities are experiencing an increasing and growing need to invest in resiliency and to adapt to the changing climate. It's important to ensure that our money is spent in the best possible way, both in terms of the reduced damages and the co-benefits that we create from the measures that we implement. When a city or city agency comes to us, they have very often already decided in investments in resiliency, but they need more insight and more detailed knowledge of their flood risk. So we work with the city or the city agency together to develop and to determine their risk and their possible solutions. This includes help in managing the stakeholders, authorities, and also often to engage citizens. To this end, we have developed a concept that's proven very useful for cities like Copenhagen and New York. We assess the flood risk through fully dynamic hydraulic models combined with financial models to simulate the impact of a flood. The optimum solution will often be a combination of engineered solutions like floodgates, pumping stations, drill tunnels, and so on, combined with landscape solutions like retention in parks, creation of living shorelines, new lagoons, etc. After the preparation of the master plan, we evaluate the effects, costs, and benefits. And then we go back and adjust the plan together with the city's citizens and other stakeholders. This enables us to create concrete measures for specific districts like Queens in New York City and here in Copenhagen. But we've also created similar projects in Washington, D.C., Oslo, and Gothenburg. When we know what we're dealing with on the master plan level, we zoom in to the specific project level and prepare the detailed design, often based on millimeter precise 3D scans of a street or a building. Both on master plan level and on the specific project level, we develop various alternatives and then we compare cost and benefits over time. Benefits cover both the savings on infrastructure investments and the reduced damages. We know, for instance, that in a city like Copenhagen, extreme rainfall leads to annual damages of more than $50 million per year in the present climate. By the turn of the century, this will increase due to climate change to more than $150 million if we don't act. This flood risk concept not only applies to city centers, but also to coastal areas and harbor fronts and along rivers. For instance, in Washington, D.C., we work on a project along the Potomac River where we apply nature-based solutions to protect the area against flooding from the river. So together with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, we provide very detailed modeling to take the flood risk mapping to a higher level of accuracy. So to sum up, when you invest in stormwater management and coastal protection, it's important to get that full overview in order to provide the most cost-efficient solutions and solutions that increases urban livability.